Welcome to Studio Biology. In this video, I am going to discuss the endocrine glands in frog. First of all, pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is also known as hypophysis cerebri. Here is the location of pituitary gland in the ventral surface of brain. Now it is also known as master endocrine gland, and it is divisible into three lobes. First one is anterior lobe. From anterior lobe, it gives various hormones like growth hormone. Growth hormone results in growth of body. It promotes the growth of body. So it is responsible for physical growth. Then next hormone secreted from anterior lobe is gonadotropin. Gonadotropins result in growth and functioning of gonads, very important for maintaining the reproductive functions. The next hormone is TSH. TSH means thyroid stimulating hormone. So it will stimulate the thyroid gland in frog to release the thyroxine, which is responsible for metabolism, and also it plays important role in metamorphosis, in which it converts the tadpole larva into adult frog. Next hormone is ACTH, that is adrenal cortico tropic hormone. It stimulates the adrenal gland, from which the hormones like mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids are released. Now the next is intermediate lobe. From intermediate lobe, only one hormone is released, that is MSH, that is melanophore stimulating hormone. This melanophore stimulating hormone influences the coloration of skin by altering the arrangement of chromatophores, etc. Then the third one is posterior lobe. The hormones secreted from posterior lobe are ADH, that is anti-diuretic hormone, and another one, it is also known as vasopressin, and it results in increased absorption of water in uriniferous tubules. Thus reducing the excretion or release of urine. Volume is reduced in excretion, retention of water occurs in body. Next gland is pineal gland. Pineal gland is also single like pituitary gland, and it is termed as epiphysis cerebri. It is the part of diencephalon, part of brain, and the hormones released by epiphysis cerebri or pineal gland is melatonin. So melatonin hormone is released, and important functions of melatonin hormone are: it alters the skin color, and it inhibits the functions of gonads. The next one is thyroid glands. These are two in number, thyroid glands, and this thyroid gland, this pair of thyroid gland, secretes thyroxine hormone. This thyroxine hormone is having two functions, that is, it regulates the metabolism in the animal, and another one is it results in metamorphosis. Metamorphosis in frog means conversion of tadpole larva into adult frog. Iodine is required for the formation of thyroxine hormone. Next is parathyroids. These parathyroids are two in number, that is one pair, and these secrete PTH, that is parathormone. This parathormone plays an important function of maintaining the calcium and phosphorus balance in blood by increasing them. So this hormone results in retention of calcium and phosphorus in blood. So this is all about the endocrine glands and their function in frog. Thanks for watching this video.